NC State had a very good 2018 season. They really surprised me, and I really was surprised as to how well they did. I really wasn't expecting a lot from them before the season started, but of course, those seniors that they had a very good senior class last year, but how are they going to do in 2019? That is what we are going to be going over today. This is NC State's schedule preview and also our first ACC schedule preview of the year. We're going to be going over a few players that this team will be losing, who they're going to be returning, and also we're going to be looking at their schedule for the first time this offseason. They went 9-4 last year. They had a great 2018 season, but can they repeat is the great question, or is the big question for next season. And it's going to be tough, I do believe, because they're losing Ryan Findley at quarterback. They're losing Gallahapsey. Also two big receivers, and they also lose three starting offensive linemen, two defensive linemen, and one linebacker and a safety. So really defensively, they're not really losing a whole lot, four starters. But then on the offense, though, may struggle a little bit next season with losing their quarterback and a running back, two main receivers. It will be tough. It will be tough next season, I do believe. But yeah, the defense should improve, I do believe, just because they're not really losing a whole lot. How similar will 2019 be? I think it'll actually be a pretty similar season. Nonetheless, even though they're losing quite a few players, I still think this is going to be a dangerous team next season. We could expect to see a few, then they upset a few teams like next season. But yeah, I do think the 2019 outlook for NC State is going to be good. Should be interesting to see how they do. This is one of the teams that was more harder to predict just because of the losses that they've had, but they still do have quite a bit of talent on this team. Looking at their schedule, they face two of the Carolinas to start off the season. They play East Carolina and West Carolina, both at home. So that is going to be, should be a pretty easy start to the season. Really not expecting much from West Carolina next season at all. Then you got West Virginia. West Virginia. I'm not really expecting a lot from them next season just because they're losing Will Grier out there and stuff, and they're losing a whole lot of players on offense. Other than that, they're kind of like NC State in the fact that they're losing a lot of players on offense. Just West Virginia is losing a lot on defense as well. Definitely expect them to struggle. They also have Ball State the next week. Then you got Florida State, Syracuse, Boston College, Wake Forest, Clemson, Louisville, Georgia Tech, and North Carolina. So really not too tough of a schedule. You do have Clemson, though, and you also have Boston College and Syracuse. Really, the ones you can get into November, they'll probably be one of the easier months if you don't consider Clemson in that. But yeah, I do expect them to win five games pretty easily next season. Really not too tough of a schedule. I mean, there are three non-conference games. Those three non-conference games should all be wins pretty easily. West Virginia, I think that they should win that game pretty easily, but just since it's a road game, I'm not going to put that one in green just because I'm not very certain yet, and I can't give an accurate prediction as to whether they'll win that game or not. Then you go to Florida State. Of course, Florida State's always a tough place to play, even if they're good or bad. Then you got Syracuse, another team that's more dangerous at home. That should be an interesting game on October 10th. That is a Thursday, I believe. You got Boston College and Wake Forest on the road. Two consecutive games. They got a bye week in between them. They got Clemson at home. That's going to be your one game on the during the season to be able to mark on your calendars if you're an NC State fan. But I do believe that Clemson game, I mean, NC State, they've been known to upset some teams in the past, some big-name teams. I think that would be a huge game right there if they can beat Clemson. Of course, if they come off of a bye and a game at Wake Forest, so really, I mean, the possibility is really there. You got Louisville at home the next week. They got Georgia Tech and North Carolina to end off the season. So really, once you can get into November once again, except for that Clemson game, really Wake Forest, Louisville, Georgia Tech, all those games are very winnable. But yeah, estimated record-wise, I think 6-6 to 10-2 is your most accurate range. But if you want a more definite answer, I would say right now you can expect 7-9 wins out of this NC State team next season. Typically, I can say probably like two records, like 8-9 wins or something like that. But I'm going to leave it within a three-game range right now just because, I mean, we are very early on in the offseason still. I mean, we are just getting into March right now, I do believe. Crazy to think that, but we are still several months away from the season beginning. So, yeah, we'll be going over NC State once again in the summer for our final predictions. Yeah, stay tuned for that. Thank you guys all for watching. Let me know your guys' thoughts on NC State in the comments below. show some support and know if you'd like to, and I will see you all later.